good.
Please stand and pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Mr. Stefanik, will you take attendance, please?
Certainly. President Alessandro.
Here.
Secretary Stefanik, here. Vice President Mitchell.
Here.
Treasurer Schwag.
Here.
Trustee Guthrie.
Here.
Trustee Brazington.
Here.
Trustee Reese.
Here.
Thank you.
Welcome.
Any changes to the agenda?
We have none.
Thank you. Item 3, consent agenda. We have item A, meetings of December 26, 2016, and bills payable November 2016. Have a motion, please? Mr. Stefanik.
I move to approve the consent agenda as presented.
Support. Support, Mr. Reese. Discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries. Item 4, prearranged request to address the board. Item A, Lakeville Elementary.
Hi there. So I have a couple of things that I want to announce to you real quick. You have a gift from Lakeville staff that is the mug in front of you and the cookies. The cookie is actually a piece of art, I have to say, from one of our Oscar graduates. She is Allie Marshall. And she...
Great cookies.
Great cookies. Parchment Patriot is her company. Parchment Patriot is her company. And she does a great job. She's absolutely an artist. I like to get our former kids involved if we can, whenever possible. And the mug goes with our theme this year, which we may all be different fish, but in the school we all swim together. And so it goes with our theme. I'm going to turn it over to Christine Vince right away. She's going to talk to you a little bit about our IB self-study.
Good evening. Thank you for having me. We're going to do things a little differently tonight because we heard you're having a celebration. So
could you turn up the microphone, please?
Oh, the microphone.
It's more.
Okay. Yeah. Can you hear me?
Yep.
All right. So, our job is to inform you about our progress in the self-study. To do that tonight, we're going to do things a little bit backwards. So we are going to engage ourselves in an inquiry to learn about where we're at in self-study. So all the things that we would normally do at the beginning, I'll do at the end. All right? So we're going to begin. We have three lines of inquiry for our unit. Our first one is the meaning of transdisciplinary learning. The second is the connection between transdisciplinary learning and self-study. And the third is the process of creating transdisciplinary units of inquiry. The meaning of transdisciplinary inquiry. This is our first line of inquiry. For this inquiry, it requires active engagement. So we're going to ask you to play with us for a minute. On your chairs, you have a number. And so what we're going to ask here, and I have brought my friends here to help me.
There it is.
If you have a number one, you are going to come over here and you're going to be standing by these balloons when it's time to go. And Mrs. Rita Flynn, who is the IB coordinator at DA and OE, is going to be working with you. If you have a number two over here, you're going to be working with Mr. Nathan Spencer, the district instructional coach, and he is our elementary science guru. And if you have a number three, you are going to be over here with Mrs. Maureen Mangalino, our district ELA coach, and we're going to do a little engagement to learn what transdisciplinary learning is. Here's the task. You have balloons. Your job as a group is to keep the balloons afloat. You cannot hold on to the balloons. If they fall on the ground, you may pick them up and you may start over again. But you are simply going to do whatever you're going to do to keep the balloons afloat for 1 minute. I may make it 30 seconds, depending how we're doing. And the coaches and coordinators are simply going to observe what you're doing. Okay? So speak freely. You may begin.
All together?
We got the easy one.
So I become.
Right. And we bought it. We bought it together. You're right.
Okay, for time's sake, we're going to go ahead and stop. Thanks, Josh. Thank you very much for your participation. And if you want to just stay where you are for a minute while we get our first observations, I'm going to go around. I'm going to ask Rita, can you just share with us what you noticed?
Well, they did a marvelous job.
Let's give a round of applause.
I know this. Sometimes we do new things and it's out of your comfort zone, and we ask teachers to do that often. But what I observed today was we had language arts sometimes on the floor, science on the floor, but we picked them up and we kept them afloat. Making connections here, I hope we all are.
Okay.
And we just did a great job.
All right, thank you. And now I'm going to go to Mr. Spencer.
All right, thank you. So what I observed was that two of the balloons were taped together. That was science and social studies. And while all the balloons spent time over the left, over the right, on the ground, the science and social studies balloons that were taped together remained in the air the whole time.
Okay, excellent. Thank you very much.
And we did a great job.
And they did a wonderful job.
It was great.
And the superintendent did create a plan prior to.
Awesome!
I will say.
Okay, and last.
Okay, so our balloons had all of the different, it looks like a proton.
Yes.
Or some kind of, but anyway, all the subject matters were together, and so everyone seemed very easily and able to keep the balloon up, and they just addressed it as it came to them.
Okay.
But what I noticed is they kind of got a little bit rhythmic about it, and then they started collaborating and talking about and being a little more strategic as
okay.
well.
Excellent. Now you can go ahead and take this
all reroll.
Yeah. Thank you for participating. Okay. So and you need to stay where you're at because you're gonna be
okay.
Okay. So Nathan, if you can please stay over there. All right. So these balloons had the content areas, the disciplines on them for a reason. They represent different types of teaching. So this group, where they were all loose, and there was balloons all over the place, and sometimes we drop them, but everyone's sort of working on their own thing, and you got a balloon at a time. This represents disciplinary learning. So sometimes, everything, you have social studies during social studies time, you have writing during writing time, you have math during math time, okay? Back here, where Nathan is, we have sort of our current state of affairs. When we first began creating, became IB, for elementary, every grade level has to have 6 units. So what we did was we created these units, making connections between science and social studies, because we knew we had to do that, IB said we had to do that, and the rest of it was up to us. So that's what we did. I heard someone over there mention when you're trying to keep the balloons afloat, that this is chaos. Which sometimes it is. There's a lot of conversation, there's a lot of chaos, it's more collaboration, but we're still not where we need to be. And then lastly, over here, they're all connected. This is the representation of transdisciplinary learning. So the idea behind it may be a lot to handle at once. We're trying to teach all these content areas, but by making connections and collaborating together, it makes it lighter work, and we become strategic about it. And that's what it looks like for the teacher. Now we're going to look at what it looks like for students. So I'm going to go back to Rita, and she's representing disciplinary learning. So we have our students.
I can do it all, but not really.
So as a student trying to take this learning with them to apply it to new things, it's all over the place. So she's trying to pick things up, but the minute she tries to pick one up, something's bound to fall. And then we have Nathan. Now he's got some connections, and he's able to pick them up sometimes, but then he's still dropping them. And he's red in the face doing it. So it's a lot of work. And then lastly, we have Maureen. And the idea here, once again, is that as we make connections, it's lighter work for the students to carry with them so that they can then take that learning and apply it to new places. So it's transferable and they can have fun with it. That's what transdisciplinary learning is, and that is our current biggest initiative, is to make our units that. So that's our first line of inquiry. Now I lost the clicker.
Right here. Oh.
All right, that's our first line of inquiry. So next, the connection between this and self-study, because we're here tonight to tell you about where we're at for self-study now. For self-study, we have to inform you of our progress. We have to identify our successes, and we have to pause and reflect on new initiatives. As we are doing this as a staff, so each school has to go through this process, reflecting on where we're at. Right now, because of the way of the world, I don't know if this will ever change, we have constant curriculum changes. We have new standards. We have new resources, new programs. And many times we have teachers who come to us as coaches and coordinators and say, but how do I do all of this at once? So our problem is, there's so many curricular updates and changes. How do we make sense of it all? Our solution is to create transdisciplinary units based on the concepts that we find in our content standards. So we're going to use our standards to make our units more transdisciplinary, and that is our newest initiative. And that's what we've decided as schools to take on as sort of our heart and soul of self-study. Okay, so our second line of inquiry. The process of creating transdisciplinary units of inquiry. This is our last one. So here's an example of what we had before. This was one of our original fifth grade units. And like I said, before, we based it on our science and social studies standards. So we may have had a standard like Rita has in her hand here, where they're talking about, you want to read it?
Compare the regional settlement patterns and systems and describe significant developments in southern New England and the mid-Atlantic colonies.
So we built a unit where the central idea is multiple factors can influence the development of a region. Things that the students are studying are development of a society or civilization, differences between society's economies due to geography, and societal decision making. What content area is this? This is all social studies. Yeah, it's all social studies. So while it's great for teaching that and hitting the standards connected to that, we're missing all the other areas. So we come back to the table. And through a lot of collaboration, oops, I got too soon. That's okay. Just don't look at that yet. So we come back to the table, and now I need my help. So we come back to the table and we reread her standard, and we notice that instead of working on colonization, which is what we looked at first in societies, now we look at the word systems. And that becomes our heart and soul. Then we notice that when we look at the math for fifth grade, we have in here, understands whole number and decimal place value system. They are learning the place value systems of not just whole numbers, but they're now working on decimals. They're working on fractions. They're looking at patterns of base 10 to find the relationship between decimals and fractions and work with exponents. So once again, we have systems and structure. Then we go to science.
And in science, our cross-cutting concepts, the system can be described in its terms of its components and their interactions, And in third through fifth grade, we understand that these systems are parts of a whole, and that the smaller parts of those systems can't work, function the same way as the whole system does.
And then last, we have ELA.
So in ELA, English Language Arts, we're all about words and word relationships, and synonyms, and a synonym for system is structure. And when we look at language arts, we focus on the relationships between concepts in two different texts. We focus on the structure of texts and identifying that structure and how that structure might change or look different, and how the parts of a piece of writing would be related to the whole, analyzing parts to whole.
Okay, so now that unit of inquiry that was all about colonization and societal decision making goes from being about factors that dealt with colonization to decisions can lead to growth or imbalances within a system. So now we can talk all day long. We can talk about growth in math. We can talk about growth in reading. We can talk about growth across the board. We can talk about imbalances. We can talk about inequalities in math. We can talk about imbalances in ecosystems. We can talk about systems all across the board. So now this unit that was only one bit of your day becomes your whole day. And a teacher can know that he or she can teach with fidelity to all these programs and know that when we hit on these concepts, we are lifting the work. Okay? Anything? We good? All right. So once again, before and after. So at first it was multiple factors can influence the development of a region, and now its decisions can lead to growth or imbalances within a system. Fifth grade reflections. We, like I said, this is just, we're starting this process. This process takes a lot of time and it takes a lot of collaboration. Fifth grade from Lakeville this summer spent 3 days together trying to rework their year using sort of this process. My hope was to videotape them so you could see what it's doing to change the instruction in their classroom. But we had the power out day and we had the snow day, and those are great. But I couldn't videotape them. So I asked them to send me a tweet. So here are our tweets. Go ahead.
This is from a teacher. The transdisciplinary process is a long one, but it opens many doors for my students. Hashtag awesome. And from a student reflection, it helps you care about what you are learning.
A reading paraprofessional wanted to know more about our current unit. She said the kids keep making connections between the unit and the books they're reading with her. Hashtag transdisciplinary. Look for broad connections. Don't be afraid to make big changes. I can build ideas all through the day.
Okay, and a teacher said, it has lifted some of the load that I have on myself being in elementary. Before, IB was a separate part of the day where we did an IB lesson. This was very difficult in fifth grade because we already have a load of standards to get through in a year. To add more content made our year very difficult. Now IB is all day long. It's everything I teach. Hashtag great experience. And then I think we have another student reflection. It gives you more chances to actually use what you learn. So that's pretty awesome. That's from a student.
Okay, that's where we're at. So I said at the beginning that we're going to work backwards, and I'm going to make the connections now. So for Rita and I, the purpose of tonight helps us show you our progress in implementing the IB program. But my hope was that by showing you this and by inviting my dear colleagues who help us in this collaboration process, it would also give us an opportunity to say thank you. This is really meaty work. It takes a lot of thought and a lot of energy. It takes a lot of resources and it takes a lot of time. We couldn't do it without the resources that you help support. We couldn't do it without the people and the time. So we thank you very much for supporting us and rich programs in Oxford. And with that, I got to give my one last cue to my good old friend, Rita.
On that note, we
are going through the self-study process again. So I don't know if you remember me talking about Oxford Elementary School going through it now. Daniel Oxford is, and we're so excited. And it is called an evaluation, but I like to call it a celebration, because we get to really just celebrate the growth that we've made and to just teach other schools around the world the progress we have. And that day is March 20th and 21st. So you'll be hearing from me, and I'd love to have you be a part of that journey on that day. I know some of you came out last time for that, and I really appreciate it. Again, we can't do this without you. Team O, go Team O. So thank you again, and I just really appreciate everyone coming out here today and being a part of this journey for us, because we can't do it alone.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay. Item 5, Board of Education Matters. Item A, Superintendent Year-End Evaluation. We had a year-end review that was conducted on November 22nd, 2016 in a closed session. Superintendent Throne was evaluated highly effective by 4 board members in attendance on that date on November 22nd. I need a motion to, we have a motion on the table. Mr. Reese.
Move to approve the November 22nd, 2016 Superintendent Year-End Evaluation. The superintendent has earned a highly effective rating for 2016.
I'll support that, Dan. Support Mark. Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Motion carries.
Could I get the vote on that? Were there any abstentions?
I believe, yes.
I have to abstain because I was not present for the creation of the evaluation.
Okay. So the vote will read 6-1 abstention. 6 yes, 1 abstention. Thank you, Jenny. Thank you, Pat.
Yep.
Item 6, additional Board of Education matter. There's a recommendation for action. Mr.
Schweig. Move to approve the purchase of a custom Sports Sound Indoor Center clustered audio system from Daktronics, quote number 602182, for usage in the high school gymnasium at a cost of $32,000.
Support.
Support.
Mr. Stepik. Any discussion? I did read on the quote that did not include sales tax, but we don't. Are we have sales tax? Okay, just wanted to be sure. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Aye. Opposed? Motion carries. Item 7, curriculum instruction. Mr. Weaver.
Yeah, we are in the process of looking at purchasing classroom books, sets of books for the grades 3 through 5. As you know, we did the kindergarten through second grade. We have recently, two years ago, we did the Teachers College writing units, put them in place. This year, we put in place, or putting in the process of putting in place, the Teachers College reading units. These books go to support the units that go along with the series, and so these books will allow the teachers to be able to have literature in their rooms that specifically support, and the kids will be reading genres of literature that are associated with the units. So we'll be able to effectively teach. We are in the process of getting a little bit more input on some of the units. We do not anticipate the overall cost to change, but we are looking at switching out, just to be honest, a couple of these, what they call bookshelves, so that it aligns better with some of the transdisciplinary units that they have been creating, that they've got in place. but also more importantly, it aligns with some of the topics that they have in the classroom that they feel are needed. So we worked with fourth and fifth grade today, and Mrs. Magdaleno is giving third grade input, but with the charge that the overall price quote is not going to change, so we're staying with it. So.
Okay. Motion, please. Mr. Stupick?
I move to approve the purchase of grade 3 through 5 classroom libraries and elementary special education support for Heinemann Publishing at total cost of $229,076.85.
Support?
Or
Mr. Reese? Discussion?
Yes. Not a discussion, but just a question. And Ken, I think you may have told us this already. When will these books be available for the students, like the first set?
Probably when we ordered the previous K-2 set, we got them within about a month, a little less than that, actually. So I would think that if we were to get, and that's why we're kind of pushing on this to get this ordered now with the holiday seasons going up, mm-hmm. that we would have this for the second half of the year to help them, because they're just now really getting into the meaty part of some of the units, and to help them support them the second half of the year.
Great. Okay. Any further discussion? Okay. All in favor?
Aye. Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries. Finance and operation, Mr. Barna.
Yes, we have a winning bidder for the food servery renovation at Oxford High School. There were two bids submitted, and we are recommending the low bid to Heritage Contracting for the work that would start this month, actually, and finish in a very short period of time. So the amount is $96,736.
Okay. May I have a motion, please? Brazenton?
Move to award the contract for the food servery renovation at Oxford High School to Heritage Contracting in Clarkston, Michigan, with lowest bidder at a cost of $96,736.
Support? Mr. Schweid? Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Motion carries. Item 9, human resources.
Wish everyone a Merry Christmas.
Wow. Thank you. Item 10, student services.
Back in September, I presented some survey data, the national surveys as it related to bullying. At that time, we decided that we would initiate the OVEA surveys, K-3, so all of that data is back in the district. And Pam Fine and I are going through all that data. I'll be back after Christmas to share that.
Okay, thank you. Item 11, board policy. Joyce?
Sure. Move to approve a second reading of bylaw 0152, officers, 0175.1, school board conferences, conventions, and workshops. The following policies: 2628, state aid incentives, 5111, eligibility of resident and non-resident students, 5460, graduation requirements, 5830, student fundraising, 6424, purchasing cards, 6605, crowdfunding, 8321, criminal justice information security, 9700, relations with special interest groups.
Support?
Support.
Mr. Reese, any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Aye. Opposed? Motion carries. Item 12, unscheduled audience participation. Everybody's so far away today.
Yeah.
Sorry about that. We wanted to
come sit in the couches.
Hey. Yeah.
It's more comfortable.
Okay. Nobody? All right. Item 13, clarification.
Not needed.
Not needed. Item 14, final board comments. Before we get to final board comments, I'll do this before or after. My preference, I'm going to do it before.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Kim, will you come up here, please?
Come on.
front and center.
You didn't think you were going to get by without coming up.
Yeah, I did.
Just a little plaque, and it says, Kim Shoemaker, with gratitude and appreciation for 7 years of service to Oxford Community Schools Board of Education, and it has the years you served in the positions.
Said it before, like it really was an honor, really, to grow as a person with each of you. So I don't look good. Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah. Thank you.
Okay, Jim. This one says, Jim Reese, with gratitude and appreciation for 5 years of service to Oxford Community Schools Board of Education and your years of service.
Thanks for getting me involved.
Well, don't sit down.
You know you're next.
I don't know if I say the best for last or the longest for last. I'm not going to go with oldest because you'll still probably whoop me. But this one says, Carol Mitchell, with gratitude and appreciation for 14 years of service to Oxford Community Schools Board of Education. Started in 2002 and finishing up in 2016.
Can you please let me stand up here and let them stand around behind you?
That's usually what we do, is just stand around.
Just stand around here. You stand, you might want to come in because you won't be all in the picture. Just right there on the edge of the purple circle, right there. Right here,
right by my shit.
Thank you. You three stand up here. If you guys could just be the background, that's fine.
Yeah.
I'm back.
Good night.
Mr. Reese.
Right here. Thank you.
Now Matt's going to have some artistic code on this.
Yeah. Cheers, are we back, boys?
I almost sat down. Okay, final board comments. We're going to start on my right. Jenny?
Just a privilege to be here again tonight. Thank you for my second meeting. And it's really been wonderful to sit at the table with both Carol and Jim.
Mr. Schweig.
Just like to compliment Jim and Carol and Kim on their years of service, and I appreciated working with them also.
First of all, I love the presentation tonight. I remember hearing it a year ago, where they were and now where they're at now, and really exciting. And they spent so much time thanking us, and I think we should be thanking them. They're the one putting in the hard work. So I'm grateful to hear all of that information. And at first, when she started talking about it, I was so confused of how they were going to, and just the way they described it was great to me. And I can see the benefits of that. Kim, thanks so much. It's been great getting to know you over the last couple years. I think I can really treat you as a friend now. I like that. Jim, been a friend for a long time. thanks for getting me involved in this. I really do like it. All that I can give back to the community. And Carol, what a trooper. What a trooper. Loved going to conferences with you and doing all that learning that we did and having fun. Really, really, really going to miss you guys. Sorry. Thank you.
Jim?
Great presentation. That will be one of the things I miss the most out of, you know, working with these great people. But the teachers and the always just so bright, and the ideas they come up with and the way they explain things so clearly so that we can understand it. I'm really going to miss that. That's my favorite part, visiting different schools and seeing all the kids do the presentations. It seems like every aspect of my life when I'm raising kids, you know, you're living the moment, and sometimes it seems like you're living it and it's taking forever. And sometimes the school board was like that, other times it went fast, but all of a sudden you blink your eye and 5 years are gone, and it's passed and it's over with. So I would just say the new board members enjoy every minute of it. And Kim, it was great serving with you on the board and getting to know you, and I wish you all the best. Carol, I talk about a trooper. That is a long haul. I'm just really proud of you and all the time that you put in all those years. It's just incredible. I don't want to give up the mic because it's my last chance. So I wrote this long speech. But I'm going to miss everyone at the table. Ken, you know, I joked about your presentation because you made everything so clear when you present about what's happening with the district and curriculum. Excellent. Just, we have the greatest people here. Sam, very good job. It's really good getting to know you, even though it was a short time, but you know, just great. Just great. Denise, you do an awesome job. Nancy, incredible. We have the best people in this district, the best teachers. I'm confident this new board is going to continue to carry on. I'm glad that my good friend Colleen Schultz came, who also had a long haul on the school board. Going to meet up with a good friend I served with, Bill Keenest, and all the board members that I served with previously. It was just an honor to be able to sit in this chair. And they call it, you know, service. This is really nice, but, you know, it's you do this just because you want to volunteer to do something. And you know, it's great getting plaque. I'm not trying to say anything about that. It's like, I don't think that I did anything except sat in this chair. You know, it's a volunteer position. I was happy to do it. I was glad I got elected, and I'm going to miss all these great people. All right, that's it.
Very good. All right.
Just once again, thank you to the IB group that presented, and I'm really appreciative of how reflective they are the second time going through creating these transdisciplinary units. It's very important just to look at what we've done and only get better. So I'm really excited to see the reflection. And once again, thank you to Kim and to Jim and to Carol. And I would disagree. It is service and it is a labor of love, but it's a lot of work. And I really, really respect all the time and effort the three of you have given this board and the community. And thank you.
You know, to see the presentation, to see the type of, not the type, the amount of thought that goes into educating our students is amazing. It really, truly is. And it's really a testament to the work that everybody in this district does and for the years of service and what this board, previous boards, Bill, Colleen, Carol, Kim and Jim all believed in this district. We didn't get to where we are today overnight. It took a long, long time. And you guys had that ball rolling, and I appreciate that. Kim, we had a lot of conversations back and forth, and it's been very, very good for me to have somebody like you, maybe a much different thought process than I have, and to bounce things off of, and I really, truly appreciate that. Jim, you know, anytime I wanted to see, maybe I wasn't feeling great about how things were going, you just talk to Jim. And Jim gets you going, it's like, oh, this, everything's great, everything's great. And you fire everybody back up, and I'll truly miss that, I really, really will. And Carol, I don't know if it's between you and Colleen for years of service, and I don't know if it's you or Colleen, both of you guys, I think, kind of got me here and said, yeah, why don't you run for a board position? And I thought, these ladies are crazy. But I wasn't wrong, you're right. Crazy. But I truly appreciate you having the both of you having the confidence in me that I could grow as a person and do the job that we're doing. And so congratulations. Enjoy your Tuesdays off. And I look forward to working with the next board. We're going to continue to do good work. And I'm sure I'm going to get a call from Carol. Big Danny, what's going on? And I welcome those phone calls. So, yep. Next.
Last.
You said you for at least 14 years. You can have last month.
All right. Well, I also wanted to thank the teachers for the IB presentation. I'm sitting here remembering way back when I didn't even know what IB was. This is going to be too hard. But to be part of that and the international program, OVA, it is, I just feel good that it has benefited all the students. That's it, I can't. Sorry.
Mr. Throne?
I appreciate the teachers tonight as well, and bringing their own personality and how maybe we teach differently today than we did even just a couple of years ago. I want to do a quick shout out today as a part of our partnership with Rotary. We had over 200 senior citizens up at the high school today for a luncheon, and Karen and her crew did just a tremendous, tremendous job, and Todd helped out, and we had our NHS and our leadership group and students were helping greet the senior citizens and get them seated and bringing them their lunch, and just a phenomenal program this afternoon. And so I really thank you for all the effort that went into that. So I appreciate that. And I think I'll just, I've talked with the board members individually, and I told them how much I appreciate their service.
And under other?
Were we going to discuss organizational?
We don't have those other two. We don't have the time now on here, so we'll cover that.
Okay.
So just maybe to take off what Mark said, some things to think about for the new board coming on is that immediately in January you're going to have the election of your officers, the role of the officers, review the format of the board meetings. You probably should look at your code of ethics again and come to an agreement, review that, look at your appointments. You have had a few committees in the past, not a lot, but whether it's your policy committee or those types of things, you may want to think about just who you want to put together for those committees. And then lastly, I would suggest that maybe you look to review your bylaws. All important things that need to take place right at the beginning of the year.
Dan, Bill, and Colleen would like to say a few words.
I'm sorry. Is that?
Come on, don't create mine up. Grab the microphone.
Okay.
Anyone?
No, better.
That one. Okay. Thank you. And Carol, I am late again for a board.
my 50 mile commute, I did that just for Carol.
So, how appropriate, right?
I think this is my first. What's going on?
I think it's on. What you get?
Push and hold that button.
Test. Okay. I think this is the first board meeting I've been to since my last board meeting. So I apologize to Kim for not being at her last, because we served together. And I just felt compelled to be here for a lot of reasons, to recognize Carol and Jim for their service. And also perhaps to apologize to Jim for somewhat talking him into this, or, you know, incredible journey that he was on. And I just want to thank all the board members for their service. It was one of the most amazing things I was ever a part of. I had no idea. I think within the first month of serving the board is when we privatized the custodial services in the meeting at Leonard. And it was quite an experience. And it was, for me, I didn't have a real precedent. So I thought, well, this must be how these meetings go. I think I was the only one we had to call the sheriffs to that I was involved with. But the one thing I wanted to say about the members is the selfless dedication that they have shown to the district. I think we went through some tumultuous times over the last decade, perhaps the most critical one in our district. Perhaps that's yet to be determined or to be realized, but I think very critical times. And I just want to say something in particular about Jim, because I don't know of anyone. We're all very selfless in what we do, or we wouldn't be here tonight, but I want to give him special accommodations, if you will. I met Jim, I think the first time we really got to know each other was with the turf project. And Jim and Dan and two others, we decided we were going to try to find a way to get turf. Mark was very involved with it as well for the high school football field. And I knew right away that he was selfless and committed to the community, committed to the kids, and committed to making our district better. And shortly thereafter, and I think this deserves to be said, I think you all appreciate why I'm saying it, but Jim's oldest son, Dylan, is entering his senior year, decided not to play. Okay, kids make decisions. We all don't agree with everything our children do. But here's a man who's committed to this project, and his son decides not to play his senior year. And I stand before you saying, I had two boys play football. I don't think there's any way in the world I would have been at that stadium every single game doing what he committed to do for this district while he's looking out on the field and his son's on out. This is a special human being that I'm just, you know, privileged to be a part of and working together with. And I think those of you that have children involved in activities can appreciate that reality. Every single game where they're raising money, we're, you know, trying to sell, you know, the turf idea to our community. He didn't miss a beat. He was so committed to that project. And everybody knows what we went through with that. It was quite an ordeal, but we got it done, thankfully. And then I think it was probably Colleen and I that were the impetus in talking Jim into running for the board. And I, from my perspective at least, I don't think anybody took as much grief or has had to deal with as much as he did as president and as a board member. It was some tumultuous times. We all went through it. But through it all, and Carol's the same, the focus was on the kids. It was on nothing else. And there were some rough, rough times, believe me. And like I mentioned about how he stayed with the turf project, There were times, from my perspective, and I wasn't, my tenure ended during the time Jim was on the board and Carol was on the board. There were some times where I'm like, this isn't worth it. But he didn't have that approach. He was selfless, he was dedicated, he was committed to the district and the kids. So I wanted to publicly commend my friend for that. And I want to remind all of us of something that, again, is why we're here. And I talked to a few people at work today about what I thought about doing. And there's some of the same people. One person that works for me, his wife's in education. He's very familiar with our district. And over the years, he went through that journey with me when I was on the board. And some of the things we had to deal with, some of the external issues we had to deal with, you know, the people in the community that didn't always agree with what we were doing, that, you know, find reason to criticize and complain about everything it seemed we were doing. And we're all familiar with who they are. And he would always ask me, he would say, is your enrollment up? And I go, yeah. What are people complaining for? Are you laying off teachers? No. Are you cutting programs? No. And he was absolutely astounded at the stuff that we had to go through. Because from the outside, what this district has done is unprecedented in many ways. For me, for years, we were the only district in Oakland County that had an increase in enrollment every year, didn't have to cut programs or cut teachers. So through it all, I think it taught me a lot of lessons. I trust it taught everybody a lot of lessons. And what I want to do is read something to you right now, because I talked to a few people at work about doing it, and they agreed that I should do it. And it's a plaque that we have out at the stadium for our turf project. And it's called The Man in the Arena, which I think a lot of you should be familiar with. But I have this posted behind my desk in my office. And having worked for the Lions for 32 years, I think you can all relate to criticism. Okay. So I refer to this over the years quite a bit. Not so much this year, thankfully. But and as I was printing this off today, I noticed that LeBron James, at a press conference after one of the playoff games this year, referred to this speech. So it transcends generations. I mean, here's one of the greatest basketball players of our generation. And he referred to this in a press conference about all the criticism and all the struggles that he went through trying to bring Cleveland a championship, which he ultimately did. But I just thought it was appropriate to read it as a tribute to all the board members and everybody that serves our community, our district, our teachers, our administrators. It's the man in the arena. It's not the critic who counts, not the man who points out how the strong man stumbles, or where the doer of deeds could have done them better. The credit belongs to the man or woman who is actually in the arena, whose face is marked by dust and sweat and blood, who strives valiantly, who errs, who comes up short again and again, because there is no effort without error and shortcoming, but who does actually strive to do the deeds, who knows great enthusiasms and great devotions, who spends himself in a worthy cause, who at the best knows in the end the triumph of high achievement, and who at the worst, if he fails while daring greatly, so that his place shall never be with those cold and timid souls who neither know victory or defeat. And I think that speaks volumes for each of you here and those that serve our district. So that's my little thank you to everybody, and I appreciate the opportunity to have a little moment here tonight. Thank you.
Meeting adjourned.